Hi students, coming to our next topic, that is programmed I/O interrupt. So what is this programmed I/O interrupt? Before going to know about this programmed I/O interrupt, you have to know about the three techniques that are used by the I/O devices. So three techniques of I/O are programmed I/O, interrupt driven I/O, and DMA. So these are the main three techniques of I/O. Why we are using these techniques? These techniques are used to exchange information between user and CPU. So to exchange information between user and the CPU, you need a technique to transfer the data from user to the CPU. So user is the person who is operating the system and the CPU is the processor who executes the instruction. So in between them, you are having some I/O devices and the memory. So these I/O devices and memory will use it to communicate between the user and the CPU. So here these I/O devices and memory uses these three techniques to exchange information between user and CPU. So here the I/O devices may be a mouse, monitor, keyboard. The memory may be the internal memories or the external memories. So let us coming to the first technique, that is the programmed I/O interrupt. So what is this interrupt? This interrupt is nothing but you call it as a suspension of process. Suspension of process. Suppose the CPU is executing some instruction, suddenly an interrupt occurs. So that interrupt may be anything, that hardware interrupt or software interrupt. Hardware interrupt is nothing but an interrupt occurs with the help of some external event. And the software interrupt is interrupt caused by some special instruction. So interrupt may be from external devices or some with the help internal devices, whatever the interrupt may be. So that will be that interrupt occurs. Whenever the interrupt occurs, the CPU stops that instruction, whatever it is executing. It takes the interrupt request. After the completion of interrupt request, again the CPU continues with this work. Continues with its work. So that is this interrupt. So what is this programmed interrupt? So let us see about the programmed interrupt. Let us take one example about the programmed interrupt. How this program I/O will be executing. So first, it issues read command to I/O module. The CPU first issues read command to I/O module. So after that, it reads status of I/O module. Means the CPU is checking whether the I/O devices is ready to accept the data or it ready to send the data. Means reading the status of I/O module. So suppose if it checks the status. If error condition is occur, that program will be quit. Otherwise, if it is not ready, means the I/O devices is doing some other work and then it is not ready, again it reads the status of I/O module until it is ready. So suppose the I/O module is ready to send the data or to receive the data. So whenever it is ready, the CPU read word from I/O module. So the data will be read by the CPU. So after reading, the CPU executes the instruction. Or it sends the data, it writes the word into memory. So CPU write the data into memory. So if it is done, it executes the next instruction. If it is not done, again it goes to the starting step. Means again it issues read command to IO module. The CP issue read command to IO module. After that, it reads the status of IO module. If the IO module is ready to send the data, then the CPU will take that data and write that data to the memory. Suppose if the IO module is not ready, again it reads the status of IO module. Here the CPU has to be wait until the IO operation has to be completed. So this is one of the main disadvantage in the programmed IO interrupt. Means here the CPU issues a command, then waits for IO operation to be completed. Here the CPU, if the CPU is faster than the IO module, then the method is wasteful. So this is about this IO module. So the common IO programming task here is to transfer a block of words from an IO devices and store them into memory buffer. So the main concept of this programmed IO interrupt is to transfer a block of data. Transfer a block of data. From where to where? From IO devices to memory. So it stores the which device is sending the data from IO to memory? The CPU is sending the data from IO to memory. So until the IO operation is completed, the CPU has to wait until it issues the read command. So here the wastage time is more in the programmed IO interrupt. Thank you.